Now we are moving to configuration tab. This is the third tab. And here we have some deeper configuration of the STM32. In case that you can see, I not select any peripheral. I have here also the default clocks. Then I have here only three default system peripherals. One is the RCC, then reset and clock control, the NVIC, the Nestec Vector Interrupt Controller, and the DMA controller, which I can use without any IP activated. They are always present. Okay, in RCC, we have some basic settings, mainly related to the voltage. In case that I change the voltage, then it's also sometimes necessary to check the related peripherals like the instruction and the data cache or the prefetch buffer, and also to set the correct flash latency. Here is not visible on the default clocks, but in case that I here change the clocks to the maximum, I here need to confirm to change the clock source. If I change the clocks to the maximum, you can see that here I automatically configure the flash latency. In case that I here put the voltage, for example, 1.8 volt, you can see on this is not possible to run the prefetch buffer, and also my flash latency was changed. In case that I put it back, then I change the correct number of the wait states. This is important in case that you are not running on the 3.3 volt. On our Nucleo kit, we always running from the 3.3, then we will not change this parameter. And also here is possible to change the power voltage scale to decrease or increase the consumption and increase the performance of the regulator. Additionally, in the each configuration tab, it's possible to define your own constants. For example, in case that I want here to have the constant which remind me the HSI clock, then I put here the name, and the value will be, I think here, the 16 megahertz. Then I can define this constant, and this will be also generated into my project. Then I can use this constant. This is common for all the peripherals which we have in the configuration tab. Then you can use it as you want to define your own constants. And last part here is also, here is possible to enable the interrupt from the RCC. Here is only one, is the RCC global interrupt, mainly is used when we, for example, switching the clocks to notify the user that the second clock are ready and we can switch on them. That now, for our examples, we will not use the interrupts here. This is everything for this configuration. The second basic system per IP, which we can set here, is the vector controller. It's also common for the all STM32. You can see that we have one active interrupt, which is the SysTick timer. SysTick timer is used in our library to keep the 1 millisecond time base, mainly used for the delays. You can see we have no other interrupts enabled. And also you can see we can set the preemption and the sub priority for each interrupt. In case that you have the different microcontroller than M4, mainly M0, then you don't have the sub priorities. About the priorities and sub priorities, we will be talking a little bit later during our hands-ons. Then when we will try to work with the interrupts, we can also do some hands-ons with the changing the priorities, then don't worry. And the last peripheral, which is always present here, is the DMA, because we can use also the DMA for the memory-to-memory transfer. We can use the DMA to transfer data from the different related peripherals, like USART, but we can also use the DMA to create memory-to-memory transfer. About this, we will talk a little bit later. You can see that here is also a lot of empty space, but in case that we enable the periphery, for example in the pinout, I can enable the additional periphery, the SPI. In case that we return here, you can see now we have here also available the SPI. We have also the GPIOs, because the SPI using here the GPIOs. They are also related. Then we open the SPI and you can see you can set the pascaler for the SPI. Again, the pascaler, its count from the base frequency here from the clock tree, from the APB1 or the APB2 bridge. And you can deeper configure the SPI. About this we will talk a little bit later when we will be working with the SPI and the peripherals more deeply, but for this we need also the knowledge about the library. That this will be not for now. And we will talk about this a little bit later. Then here in this tab you can find some deeper configuration of each IP which we have. Also some IPs which are not related to the pinout, it's also possible to enable here on the left side. For example, the CRC can be also enabled here. If we go inside, you can see there is no parameter to configure. In case that we enable the watchdog, you can see we can set the parameters of the watchdog, the counter, the window value. Then there are some deeper configuration of the IPs which are not related to the pinout. Okay, this is all from this tab. We will use this tab many times during the next hands-ons, then don't worry.